question from Evan, and my voice is coming back, so it's a little bit off right now, so I sound like a, everybody said I had like a smoking problem tonight. But got a question from Evan. He says, what's your favorite attack from the knee cut slash cut through pass? So Evan, I'm going to show you the sort of the submission that I look for, the sort of the attack situation I look for from a knee cut pass. Thank you for the question, brother. As always, this is my lovely assistant, Mr. Adam Wilson. So from a cut through pass, again, there's lots of variations. I don't want to get too deep in the weeds with that today. But again, we're getting in the position, bang, we cut through. A lot of times what happens after a cut through pass is the person will be fighting to get up on their side, right? Because again, if you're in a side control or if you're in a passing situation, if Adam's not flat, I don't have side control, right? And he can still fight. He still has escape options. And so a lot of times guys fight very hard. They either fight hard to stay towards you or they'll fight really hard to go away from you. But a lot of times it's hard to roll away from the cut through. So a lot of times they're here, and if I feel them go for an underhook, I kind of invite it in. And a lot of times guys are doing that because if we go through a cut through pass, a lot of times we're dominating either a gi here, like a collar, or we're dominating this underhook. And so as we slide through, a lot of guys are gonna fight for that. Boom, I like that, because that's gonna open up the step over. So for me, if you've watched any of my drill videos, you've seen this over and over and over again. I take a big step. When you take the step needs to be bigger than smaller. If we do a small step, I end up falling to my butt. But if it's a good big step, bang, step over right here. Now I'm right here attached to his back, okay? And why this is important is because if this guy is trying to turn towards me, more than likely he's going to try to come up. He's not gonna just stay on the side. He's gonna try to come up and do something. So as I feel the underhook, I feel the guy coming up into me, I take a step, boom, right here. Now, a couple things can happen. One is, and I share this with you guys, I found that this is really useful for me, and maybe this will be useful for you. Years ago, I was so concerned with, like, let's say if he got turtled up, I would be concerned with getting the strong position, getting the hooks and all that stuff, and then taking the back and then systematically working to the choke, right? But one of the things that I've found, man, has been so useful, come back down, is that as soon as I'm here, instead of like going for the position first, as soon as I'm here, like as he's going, boom, right here, and just, I mean, just going for the neck. Because what happens is a lot of times people in these, and this is gonna be obviously a quick transition, a lot of people look for the position first, and then they go for the submission, which is, you know, position before submission is common, sort of like little, you know, motto for jiu-jitsu. But I really find that sometimes with the rear naked choke, before I'll get the choke sometimes, right here, and then they'll start moving and rolling, and I'll end up like following here, and then getting the hooks on the fly, okay? So I'm giving you an idea of what I'm doing, which is I'm trying to chase the back. Okay, I'm trying to get to the back, but giving you the other little addition of look for the choke sometimes before you even go for the back, okay? So again, cut through. Boom, right, maybe he starts to get the underhook. As he starts to turn, boom, I step over. And again, if I can get here, I can try to switch off to the regular back take, no problem, okay? But look for it. A lot of times, in these transitions, I'm here, he's worried about the hooks, so everything comes in here, and then a lot of times, boom, we can go right in here for the rear naked, or even a bulldog choke in no gi, okay? So if you were asking me about my favorite attack, it's using the step over after the cut through to come around to the back and have some sort of attack from here, some sort of choke from this position. So Evan, I hope that gave you an idea of something you could do after the cut through pass. When you cut through, if you feel them coming up into you, use that step over and then immediately start attacking the neck, start taking the back, start looking for all sorts of options from there. So I hope this is helpful to you. I'm finished. Adam.